Hi, my name is Myra Kagete and welcome to a new video. In this lesson, I'm going to teach you how to use the phrases do you mind and would you mind. We usually use do you mind and would you mind when we want to politely ask someone to do something or when we want to politely ask someone's permission. Ibig sabihin, ginagamit natin ang do you mind and would you mind una kapag tayo ay humihingi ng pabor sa isang tao na gawin niya ang isang bagay, o kaya naman pangalawa ay kung tayo ay humihingi ng permiso sa isang tao.
To politely ask someone to do something, you can use the following structures. The first one is do you mind plus a verb in the ing form. Examples: do you mind closing the door, please? Do you mind carrying these boxes, please? Do you mind checking the receipts, please? Do you mind reading this for me, please? Tandaan nyo ha, after ng do you mind, kailangan ang gagamitin natin ay ang verb in its ing form. The second structure is would you mind plus a verb in the ing form. Examples: would you mind closing the door, please? Would you mind carrying these boxes, please? Would you mind checking the receipts, please? Would you mind reading this for me, please? In these questions, pinalitan lang natin yung do ng would.
When we want to politely ask someone's permission, then we can use the following structures.
To politely ask someone's permission, you can use the following structures. The first one is, do you mind if I plus a verb in the present form? Do you mind if I borrow this chair? Do you mind if I turn on the air conditioner? Do you mind if I sit here? Do you mind if I leave this here? Tandaan nyo ha, after ng do you mind if I, kailangan ang verb na gagamitin ninyo ay nasa present form. Borrow, turn on, sit, leave. The second structure is, would you mind if I plus a verb in the past form? Examples: would you mind if I borrowed this chair? Would you mind if I turned on the air conditioner? Would you mind if I sat here? Would you mind if I left this here? As you can see, ang mga verbs na ginamit sa sentences na ito ay ang borrowed, turned on, sat, and left.
Now, how do we respond when someone asks for our permission using those phrases? For example, if someone asks you, do you mind if I borrow this chair? Or would you mind if I borrow this chair? And kung okay lang sa'yo, anong isasagot mo? Should you say yes or no? What does the word mind mean in those phrases? Remember that the word mind has different definitions. In these phrases, however, the word mind can mean to be annoyed or to feel annoyed or to be upset about something. Kapag ang isang tao ay annoyed or upset, ang ibig sabihin niyan, ang taong ito ay naiinis o masama ang loob. And if we think about it, do you mind and would you mind can mean, does it bother you? Kung ganyan ang tanong sa'yo, paano mo sasagutin? Kung okay lang sa'yo, ang isasagot mo ay, no, I don't mind. Or simply, I don't mind. Or no, go ahead. Kung isipin mo, parang baliktad, di ba? Okay lang sa'yo, pero ang sasabihin mo ay, no, I don't mind. Or no, go ahead. Kasi nga, ang ibig sabihin ng, do you mind if I borrow this chair, halimbawa, is, does it bother you if I borrow this chair? O kaya, maiinis ka ba or sasama ba ang loob mo kung hihiramin ko ang upuan na ito? Ngayon, kung hindi naman okay sa'yo na hiramin niya yung upuan, then you can say or you can start your answer with, I'm afraid or I'm sorry, but. If for you to sound polite with your response, then you can start your sentences or your answers with I'm afraid or I'm sorry, but. After ng phrases na yan, you can explain the reason why you don't want this person to borrow this chair.
Anyway,
you can also say, do you mind, with a rising intonation. If you want to tell someone that he or she is annoying you or bothering you, okay? Kumbaga, sarcastically, you will say, do you mind? Okay, with that facial reaction. Kumbaga, ibig sabihin, pwede ba? Kung na-translate natin siya sa Filipino. That way, do you mind can mean you're annoying me or you're bothering me.
Now let's do an activity. Which of the following sentences is correct? Letter A, do you mind to fix this broken chair? Letter B, do you mind fixing this broken chair? The correct answer is letter B. Do you mind fixing this broken chair? Remember, when we want to politely ask someone to do something, we can use do you mind plus the ing form of the verb, or would you mind plus the ing form of the verb. Number 2. Which of the following sentences is correct? Letter A. Do you mind if I don't go to your party? Letter B. Do you mind if I didn't go to your party? The correct answer is letter A. Do you mind if I don't go to your party? Remember that when we politely ask someone's permission, we can use the following structures. Do you mind if I plus a verb in the present form? Or would you mind if I plus a verb in the past form? Number 3. Which of the following sentences is correct? Letter A. Would you mind if I leave the package at the door? Letter B. Would you mind if I left the package at the door? The correct answer is letter B. Would you mind if I left the package at the door? Katulad ng sinabi ko kanina, when we want to politely ask someone's permission, we can use do you mind if I plus the present form of the verb or would you mind if I plus the past form of the verb. Kapag would you mind if I ang gagamitin ninyo, kailangan nasa past form ang inyong verb.
Thank you very much for watching this video. If you learned something new today, please don't forget to click the like button. You can also share this video with your friends and subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed yet. At pasensya na kayo, because obviously I'm still having some difficulties speaking with my braces on. I'm still trying to get accustomed to them, but I hope eventually I'll get used to them. Thank you very much for your time today.